Hello and welcome. I'm the Big Shot Critic, and today it's my first Halloween video. Ooh.
Just behind me is Mesa Community College. I was attending there a few years ago just before I dropped out. Now, there's a few reasons I dropped out, but ultimately it was because I wanted to be who I wanted to be and not who everyone else told me I should be. We all have those moments in life where conventional wisdom goes against what's inside, where everyone is telling us to go left and we want to go right. The house with the clock in its walls is about being true to yourself.
Lewis is our main character. He's an orphan who moves in with his uncle and is introduced to a world of magic. And he wears goggles because he's a big fan of Captain Midnight, the main character of his favorite show.
The point is, he's a weird kid, and he has things about him that make him an outcast at school. But it's those very things that become assets and help him save the day.
Being true to yourself doesn't mean truth is relative and you're always right. Lewis makes some serious mistakes in the movie with heavy consequences. Right is right and wrong is wrong.
But being true to yourself does mean that your unique perspective and approach to things can be your greatest asset. Look at anyone who has changed the world in any way. Did they get there by being who others expected them to be, or by being true to what's inside?
Lewis is just a kid, and he is annoying sometimes, but the movie does a great job getting the message across to be true to yourself. I was all set to skip this movie, but my girlfriend wanted to see it, and I wasn't opposed, so we went and saw it. In the end, she didn't like it that much, but I liked it enough to buy it. The performances from Jack Black and Cate Blanchett are amazing. The movie is funny, but it never undercuts the drama. It's for children, but it never disrespects the audience. A mistake made by so many children's movies. Lewis is played by Owen Vaccaro. His performance is way better than I could do at 10 years old, but it really isn't strong enough to carry the movie. His first crying scene is particularly bad, and he just doesn't have the screen presence that the movie demands of him. Younger audiences won't have a problem with this, but they will have a problem with the scarier moments in the film. There are some effects that I'd say will be horrifying for anyone under the age of 9 or so. They're creepy to me. I see this as the main failing of the movie. Audiences under 9 will be too scared, and audiences over 9 won't buy the performance of the lead actor. So I don't know if the movie will get a perfect score from anyone. But again, the solid humor and the supporting cast more than saves the movie for me. I cannot overstate how funny Jack Black is. He was eating chips in the commentary for the deleted scenes, and I was dying.
But this joke wasn't quite landing. It was just kind of like a B joke.
I mean, you don't know how hard it is for me during these the DVD commentary not to eat my honey Dijon chips.
Why don't you eat them?
They're so loud.
Eat them. No, that's okay.
No, it'll ruin the...
No, it won't. It's good. Enjoy those chips. Oh, see, we didn't have the...
Which brings us to another reason the house with the clock in its walls is of interest, which is that it was directed by Eli Roth, of all people. Mainstream audiences will know him as the Bear Jew from Quentin Tarantino's 2009 World War II movie. No, I won't say the name. This is a family-friendly YouTube channel, okay? But Eli Roth is most well known for directing a slew of ultra-violent R-rated horror movies, known particularly for the ultra-violent aspect. So I was curious to see what he would do with a children's movie. By the time The House with the Clock in Its Walls came around, several famed horror directors had made very successful jumps to other genres, including James Wan with Furious 7, which is still the biggest box office take for any Fast and Furious movie. And in 2011, Martin Scorsese got a ton of awards from his first foray into children's movies with Hugo. Up to that point, and since then, Scorsese's been known for hard-edged mafia films and movies like The Wolf of Wall Street, which features 506 instances of the F-word. 506. I have to imagine Martin Scorsese doing Hugo was brought up when they were talking about having Eli Roth do The House with the Clock in Its Walls. So, how did Eli Roth do? I think the direction of House with the Clock is great. It's very confident. You can tell he knows what he wants. He gets the laughs and the dramatic moments. And the pace and tone are nicely done. He also has a cameo you can see if you stay sharp. Like this video if you think you can spot it in the first viewing like I did. And tell me in the comments below if you already did. And this concludes my first Halloween video. Ooh. I don't know what we're going to do next year, because that's my only Halloween movie. I give The House with a Clock in Its Walls 6 out of 10 commandments. It kept the first one. Thou shalt not bore me to tears. As always, everyone, thank you for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. And let me know in the comments below what you thought of The House with a Clock in Its Walls. Bye-bye.